I'm at least set back. Reporting.
How about this fight? Did you see Cody's fight?
I saw Cody.
What did you think? I thought he was winning it. He had him down.
He was winning. But he got caught. He got caught. But, I mean, I'm not going to take anything away from him.
No, TJ did his thing.
It's a great fight. He did his thing. But here's the funny thing. Cody caught him with the same punch in the first round that was on that videotape from the surveillance film, from the thing. So, I mean, if that punch that Cody had thrown had been 30 seconds earlier, the fight would have been over in the first round. So it's just a matter of he got caught, man. He got caught, and he'll be back.
Okay, TJ, good sportsmanship. Him and Cody, you know, they had a lot of beef. They hate each other, but they kept it professional.
Yeah.
He called out Mighty Mouse afterwards. He said, TJ Dillashaw. He said, I'm going to stop your streak. I'm coming after you. First of all, how does he go down from like 35 to what, 25?
It's a 10-pound difference, I think.
It's a lot. 10 pounds.
Yeah, but TJ's not a big guy. You know what I mean? It was the same thing. Frankie Edgar went down from 155 to 145. He was struggling to make 155 when he was making 155, so making 145 was great. TJ's not a big guy.
Is he Mayweather that he gets on a scale and he's 5 pounds lighter?
I mean, yeah. I mean, well, that's how Frankie used to be. It was a struggle for him to be at 155. Now it's great going to 145.
So break it down. Mighty Mouse, who's one of your favorites?
Mighty Mouse wins.
Why?
He's too fast, he's too technical, and he's too well-rounded.
Do you want to bet?
Again, dude, you want to take that bet? You want to bet against me again? You were betting on Bisping.
He let me down. Well. He let me down.
You know the fight I was the most upset with last night? It was the Joanna fight.
What?
And I love Rose Namajunas. I love Rose. I've loved Rose forever. You know, I mean, her partner, boyfriend, I don't know if they're married yet, Pat Barry. I had the pleasure of training with him years ago. I've always loved Rose. She's hard-nosed. She's a fighter. And she, you know, it was crazy because she had a fight and she had long hair and like her hair was getting in the way, so she fucking shaved her head. Like,
you know, I remember
like,
that.
That's when you're doing it because you're doing it for the right
reason. To make weight, right?
Yes. And she shaved her head.
How much is her weight? Does that even make sense? Could that work?
No, it wasn't so much for weight. It was a fight she was in.
Yeah.
She had hair and her hair
they
got
cut
in the
it,
way.
Yeah.
And the next fight she fought, she shaved her head.
Okay, but I'm talking about another MMA fighter, a girl that couldn't make weight, so she cut her hair really quick and then she made weight.
Oh, it depends. Yeah, it depends on how much hair you have. I know some girls with natural hair who have a ton of hair. You can probably drop a pound of hair.
So why were you disappointed?
You know, I was disappointed because Joanna starts out slow sometimes. You know, sometimes she's been hit and dropped before. And she was, she put on a lot of theatrics for this fight. She put on a lot of theatrics for this fight, and she, you know, she was trying to make the fight. And I think Rose did the perfect thing. She kept calm. She, you know, she did what Rose did. She had that 1,000-mile death stare, and she took it like with a ridiculous left hook. And Joanna didn't have time to recover like she normally does.
I will say this: in MMA, you never know who's gonna win.
Listen,
because you can lose in so many different ways.
You know, it was funny, like. I was wondering if I was going to run into you today, but I think last night's card overall was a prime example of why boxing heads hate MMA, right? Because if we have a good card, it's a great card getting to end. There were prelim fights, the Ovin St. Pierre, Ovin St. Peru versus Corey Anderson fight. It was like a light heavyweight fight. Corey Anderson was winning three rounds, like going into the third round, and he got caught with a leg kick and was out. You know what I mean? And that dude took the fight on short notice. You know what I mean? Ovin St. Peru took the fight. OSP took the fight on short notice. And gave a ridiculous fight of the night knockout.
I asked Robert Garcia, who's the best promoter in the history of boxing. And he said the same thing that you said. He said Don King, because he used to put on a card where all the fights could be headliners.
Yeah.
It's not like today where many times you'll have one great fight, but the undercard is very weak.
It's a snoozer, and no one tunes in.
No.
You know what I mean? Like, that's the difference. And that's the difference from people who... The casual MMA fan, I think, is more knowledgeable about MMA fighters and their records than the casual boxing fan. Because the casual boxing fan watches the big fight.
And he doesn't know on the card. Here, they do videos for them, highlights, they promote them from 0-0, 1-0.
They promote the guys from the ground up. And if you show yourself on the prelims, even if you're on the Fight Pass fight on the internet and you have a great fight, you might be on the prelim fight, which is on FS1. for the next fight. You know what I mean? There were some ridiculous fights.
But this is the difference. You only have Bellator and UFC for the most part. The big dogs.
In the U.S.?
In the U.S. But I'm talking about like major players.
Okay.
In boxing, you have six different promoters and it's so hard to promote everything.
It's so convoluted. It's so watered down. The purity of it has been lost. It's corrupt as shit.
Why do you say boxing is corrupt? How do you know?
Because, you know, it's always, I'm going to maneuver my fighter to get the best fight possible. I'm gonna duck the number one guy, Flanagan. I'm gonna vacate the belt and go to a different height weight class, so I don't have to fight the number one guy. So I don't have to lose.
But what if you say that's smart? No.
Whatever.
You want to see him fight Ray Beltran? But Ray's fighting.
It's a standard rule that you only are the best if you beat the best. Period.
Okay.
You can't maneuver your way to be the best because you didn't fight the best. If you fight a bunch of threes and fours or six and sevens, you're not the best, bro. You're paper fucking champion.
But wait, I'm gonna say one thing about what you said about UFC cards. This was the first good UFC card in a very long time.
No,
they went through
a year and a half,
their cards were not selling. Nobody was buying. Nobody was tuning in.
Maybe for you.
A lot of people, not only me. They will always tell me, boxing kicked UFC's ass tonight.
Huh?
Many times I get a message, hey, Ellie, they have two fights. Uh-huh. Boxing kicked UFC's ass.
Yeah, but how often does that happen? How many boxing cards?
This year was an insane year for boxing.
Yeah. What do you got next year? What
have
you
had
since? What have you had since?
Canelo.
Nothing. What's your next fight? Wilder and Josh?
No.
Which isn't going to happen for another year?
My next fight, Daniel. My next fight is Rigondeaux Lomachenko.
Lomachenko wins.
No, I don't know. It's a good fight.
It's a good fight.
We're going to tune in.
But guess what? They're only watching Lomachenko and Rigondeaux. They ain't watching who's on the undercard. No one knows. That's the difference, man. Like, it's quality and quantity. You know what I mean? There was that main card was great and the prelim card was great. So that's the difference. You're getting more.
Well, yesterday, Sean Porter's fight, you're probably watching UFC. He fought Adrian Granados. That was a great fight.
It was a good fight.
And then Wilder Stavern, nobody thought it's gonna end like that. Not in one round.
That was a farce.
No, I think Wilder was.
You think Wilder was too much one?
Yeah, I think Stavern Wilder the anger. Well, when you get hit, I talked to Wilder's sparring partner today, and he told me his power is something else. Like, he's been in the ring with him. He said his power is something else. He can't even describe it.
Yo, Stavern, you know, I don't know. Stavern to me looked like he got hit and then didn't want anymore.
Well, listen, when you get hit like that, he tried, he got up, he shook it off, but
Wilder... He got up, he shook it off, he was hitting in the back of the head.
But Wilder hits that hard?
I guess so. He hits you so hard, you forget what your anatomy is.
Yeah. All right, there you have it. Dwayne, Beatbox 818. Stay tuned. Peace.com. Let's get back to reporting. Reporting.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best. Ellie Setback. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. ES News. He came a long way. All the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind. Competition. He abusing them.